concerts, I think, have been around a long time. I think they're happening more and more now. I think it'd probably be kind of cool to have an entertainer in your living room. You don't have to drive anywhere or drive very far. Concerts, I think, are typically earlier than going to bars. That's a complaint I hear a lot, where they don't even start till 10:30. I have kids, you know, I gotta get up at 7. And you actually would get to know the performer, where, you know, going to a Police concert or something like that, chances are you're not gonna meet Sting that night. Chances. I grew up listening to my brother's music and CFQC radio and CKOM. So it was a lot of popular music. So you'd get Lightfoot and Anne Murray and the Saturday Night Polka Party and Sunday morning gospel stuff on the radio on the way to church. And my folks listened to like flamenco and different genres, but not a lot because the record player was broke, so.
All right. Thank you. This song requires an industrial G string, of which I don't have on the guitar.
What are you laughing at?
Industrial. The industrial G string. This is a song I wrote. It was inspired by a whole bunch of things. It was inspired by a whacked out tuning that couldn't be right. I know it's crazy, Lucy. Inspired by a movie, Rabbit Proof Fence, inspired by a guitar tuning, inspired by this music I was listening to, and a little dose of life. It's called Little One.
Ah.
my neighbors had grandkids, and one of them was a drummer. So we would, he and I and another guy would go to a local jam session. We'd go to a local jam session at the Rose and Crown and play. I played my first Jimi Hendrix song and a couple others. And then the place burnt down. And the only other place I could go as a teenager, there was a country jam, but I don't think I could get into it, and I wasn't really into country music, was Buds on Broadway. So Tim and Keith and I came here, and it was a blues jam. So we'd sort of do blues-oriented music, and I ended up kind of, sort of my first exposure, I mean, literally to blues. I'm sure I'd heard blues over the years, but didn't know what it was. So it was my education. So I'd go to the public library and take out Coco Taylor records and other records I could find of female blues singers, and talk to some people at the jams too to say, who should I be listening to? And so of course Janis Joplin got mentioned, and Etta James, and all sorts of different singers. So, but yeah, I'd come back every Saturday and try and expand the repertoire a little bit, and so it's sort of a chunk of the pie of the music that I play, and it played a big part in my musical development. It's not all I listen to. It's not all I like. I like different types of songwriters, like Sean Colvin, and Ricky Lee Jones was a huge influence growing up as well. Just good music, you know.
Well, welcome. Thanks so much for coming to the concert tonight. I'm gonna get you put you guys to work right now, if that's okay. This is a blues song by my friend Roy Forbes. He's crazy about loving me. I got a guy about 6'2". Mm-hmm. He got eyes of blue, and he's crazy about loving me.
Crazy about loving me. But I was crazy about loving me.
Crazy about loving me.
Crazy about loving me, yeah. Crazy about loving me, yeah. And there ain't one thing I can do wrong. I know I feel fine when he says he's mine. Crazy about loving me, yeah. And there ain't one thing.
Different. I just have to get my band. This is my band. Better turn it on. Turn the band. That doesn't sound very good. Turn the band on. Excuse me. What are you laughing at? Okay, wait. I have to figure out how to. Oh, wait. Come back. This is Ipod Vladislav with Honeytone. And this is a song called Starfall that was inspired by a hail storm when I was doing some writing in the Capelle Valley. There were 5 rounds of hail one night, and living in Toronto, don't see that kind of stuff too often, even though I did grow up in the prairies, but it had been a long time since I'd seen that. So it was the storm happened on the Thursday night, and Friday morning I sat down and wrote this little poem. And about 6 months later, I went back to do some more writing at Fort Capel, and was at the in the chapel where this old Farfisa organ is located, and was sitting and jamming at the Farfisa. Etc. If any of you have taken organ lessons or sat at the cheesy organs of the world. And so I sat with this lyric and found some groovy little beats and came up with what Ipad is about to play for you. So this is called Starfall. Maybe. Oh, no, that's not it. Stop. That's Erin Neville singing Hercules, but that's not what we're looking for tonight. Okay, go band, go. Even takes a wicked drum solo. Here we go. The stars fell like raindrops when the clouds sailed away, leaving them no net to land in. I reached into the night and I caught me a handful. They were shining and shimmering on my skin. Star sizes of butterflies, pennies, and bees bounced off the rooftops, covered the streets. That glitter and glow lasted only a moment, and then the stars melted away. Oh, nightfalls like these don't come all the time. When the stars tumble down with such grace from the sky, and I feel so lucky that I got to catch them. I just reached out my hand in the blink of an eye. Oh, night falls like these don't come all the time. When the stars tumble down with such grace from the sky, and I feel so lucky that I got to catch them. I just reached out my hand in the blink of an eye. Go, Ipod. Stars fell like raindrops, the clouds sailed away, leaving them no net to land in. I reached into the night and I caught me a handful, and then the stars melted away. Whoa, then the stars melted away.
The most
ridiculous way of trying to sell CDs. A late night ad.
Hi, my name's Susie Vinnick. Please buy my CD. Susie Vinnick, The Unknown Hits.
No. One guy, I think he said he would, like, go out on a, he was this L.A. guy, I can't remember his name, would go out on a date or take you out on a date or take you out to some diner or take you out to get your laundry done. And he offered all these crazy, crazy things if you checked out his music. And I think I've never really busked, which I kind of feel bad about in some ways. I think that's a good way to develop yourself as a performer, but it would also these days maybe be a good way to sell records too. I diversify, right? I sing, I play instruments, I do some jingle work. I'm a quick learn, quick study in the studio. I work as my own artist, I work in these groups, I work, get hired as a side person, as a vocalist, as a bassist, sometimes as a guitarist, mandolinist. So the flexibility has definitely been a helpful thing for me as far as being able to survive the business. So, yeah, or maybe I'll just bartend in Ireland.
She knows how to sing. Oh, she sure knows how to sing.
I make really good pierogies.
Why did you call your album Happy Here?
What I called the album Happy Here because I had a song by the same title. And Happy Here was a song, I think it ends up being about a breakup, but for me, Happy Here translates to I really enjoy getting to sing, and on the album cover, Happy Here is across my throat, and when I'm singing, I'm in a happy place.
This is Andy, everybody. She's responsible for curling my hair tonight. Mm-hmm. And make-upping my face and making me feel beautiful. Thank you.
You are beautiful.
Don't go changing. Don't go changing.
This is the title track from my latest CD. It's called Happy Here. It's a little song that Stephen Fearing and I wrote together.
Stop.